Today we are going to visit the monastery of Arkadi. It's in the foothills behind Rethymno. It's a 16th century monastery. Ancient olive tree at the courtyard. The clock tower of the 16th century church.
Hoe oud zijn die bomen zijn? Dat heb ik al een paar keer gevraagd, toch?
This old cypress is still a silent witness van de battle that took place here in 1866 when the armies from the Sultan tried to conquer the Cretan resistance force against the Sultan of Turkey. This dead tree is still a witness. It even got one piece of grenade still inside. You can see it here. The old doors of the monastery. The old doors. Stored, yeah. And the old rector table. The courtyard is beautiful. There's large storage yards. Yesterday, the pilgrims were received. They spent the night and given food by the monks. Door van de monastery. Oven for the bread. Equipment. This is to separate the corn and the wheat, the fields. The corn machine. Huge fireplace. And very loose. And I think bees or west high side, you can hear them hum. All the light. This is the darkest place on the monastery. Here in 1866, all the people from the village and all the soldiers and defenders and the people who were revolting against the Turks were gathered here. There was a 2 weeks siege of the monastery. The situation was hopeless. And they didn't have too much choice. or they would be ending up killed by the Turks or end up alive in slavery. They didn't choose for that. They gathered all the people together in this formal wine cellar. But by that time, the store is full with gunpowder. And they blew themselves up. They say, better we die than we have a life in slavery. So the place has never been restored. So the ceiling has been blown out and is still open. And they say many of hundreds of people died here on the spot. And now it's a place of contemplation. They kept it simple. A small oil lamp. Here you see the priest praying for them for the last time. You see the old people, children, women, fighters in the last moment. When this man ignites the gunpowder with his pistol and blew himself up. Here you see still one gunpowder vessel left. It's a very dark side of Cretan history. But it's also a place of courage and of hope. Lemon tree growing inside an old well. Inside a monk's cell. Small desk, a place to pray, contemplate. Food supplies. And a small hearth to cook your things. some of the clothes from the priests. This monastery is famous for making this kind of clothes. They're beautiful, from silk, embroidery. Look at the beautiful arches. Old icons. You walk across from the church. Liturgical objects. Several Bibles. You see the remnants of the people who were fallen victim to the blast. Pull themselves up. They keep them here in the cupboard. At least some of them. Thank you.